This conference will now be recorded.
Yes, thank you. So everyone can see the slides? Good evening everyone. Good evening Charmi, good evening. Yes, Jay, Jansi, good evening. Sorry for this disturbance. I don't know, the app is not working on the computer. I don't know why. Okay, so let's start. In the last class, we have completed the bone cells. So this class will try to complete this blood cells. I have given a brief introduction last time also, that what is this blood? Blood is a connective tissue. Okay, blood is a connective tissue. You should know this. It is a liquid connective tissue. Why it is a connective tissue? Because it connects all the portions of your body. So it is a part of the connective tissue. Fine. तो आपका ब्लड क्या है? वो एक कनेक्टिव टिश्यू है जो आपके बॉडी के हर एक ऑर्गन, हर एक पार्ट को कनेक्ट करता है. एंड द मेन फंक्शन ऑफ द ब्लड इज टू कैरी ऑक्सीजन एंड न्यूट्रिएंट्स एंड टू टेक अवे द हार्मफुल वेस्ट मटेरियल्स. फाइन, मतलब इट हैज ड्यूअल फंक्शन. एक तो वो ऑक्सीग्लोबिन को भी लेकर जाएगा, ऑक्सीजन को भी लेकर जाएगा, न्यूट्रिएंट्स को भी लेकर जाएगा, आपके हॉर्मोन्स को लेकर जाएगा. एंड दूसरी तरफ पे वो क्या करेगा, जो डीऑक्सी हीमोग्लोबिन है, जो हार्मफुल प्रोडक्ट्स है, उन सबको वापस लेकर आएगा. एंड वेयर इट ब्रिंग्स ऑल दीज थिंग्स, वेयर इट विल टेक दिस ऑक्सी हीमोग्लोबिन, फ्रॉम वेयर इट विल ब्रिंग दिस ऑक्सी डीऑक्सी हीमोग्लोबिन, वॉट इज द ऑर्गन, कमेंट, वॉट इज द ऑर्गन वेयर इट विल डू ऑल दीज थिंग्स. Lungs, heart. Heart is right. Lungs actually it carries all other parts of the body. Na, there are two types of the blood capillaries, the arteries and the veins. Both have blood. Okay, Shrivali, both have blood, but one is taking your oxygenated one and one is taking your deoxygenated one. But where this all this process is going on, from where they are carrying the deoxyhemoglobin, from where they are carrying the oxyhemoglobin, where they are giving this deoxyhemoglobin, it is the heart. Okay, the heart is the organ where this all process is happening. Fine. So last time we have seen that when we keep the blood, what we can see, there are three different layers. Now the lower two portions, जो आपको नीचे के दो portions दिख रहे हैं, the lower two portions, जो एकदम dark red color है and जो grey color है, the dark red one and the grey colored one, both these are called as formed elements, FORMED. They are called as formed elements because they are made up of cells. That is why this portion, the RBC and WBC and the platelets, these two portions are called as the formed elements. Fine. And the upper portion, which is the plasma, that is your liquid portion. जो आपका ऊपर का जो layer है वो एक liquid का layer है. उसके अंदर मैंने आपको पहले ही बता दिया है कि उसके अंदर क्या present रहता है और क्या present नहीं रहता है. Plasma is something which does not contain any cell, but it contains fibrinogen. And what is serum? Serum is the thing which does not contain the clotting factor, which does not contain the fibrinogen. But you have to know here this thing, that these two elements, the RBCs, WBCs and platelets, they are called as the formed elements. This question comes in your exam, that what is the portion called as formed elements, FORMED, formed elements. Formed means the cells, the RBCs, the WBCs and the platelets. Understood? Understood, everyone? Right? So it is called as the formed elements. Now, one thing you should know here, one more thing is that this RBCs, WBCs, and platelets, they are always being produced in your body, right or wrong? Is it like that once it has been produced, it will be there for the whole life, or it is producing every now and then? Which is the correct statement? They are producing every now and then, or they are once produced and they will be there for the whole life? Now and then. Two. Okay. Every now and then. Yes, right. They are produced every now and then. And why they are produced every now and then? Because their lifespan is very small. It is not like that. Ek bar heart ban jayega, to wo sirf bada ho sakta hai. Wo wapas se die hoke and wo wapas se ban nahi sakta. Your heart is for one and all. Only one time it will be formed. Only kidneys is for one and all. It will only form for one time. But there are some organs, there are some parts in your body which can be regenerated, like your skin. Skin can be formed. If it is cut, if there is an injury, skin can be formed again. Agar aapka skin mein kuch injury ho jata hai, agar aapka skin nikal jata hai, ya aapko kuch aisi problem ho jati hai jisme skin disease ho jata hai, to aapko new skin aa sakti hai. And the same thing is with your blood also. Blood can also be formed because aapka ye jo blood hai, that is having a very small lifetime. First thing, they are having a very small lifetime. First thing. Second thing, they're functioning. What is the function of the blood, the WBCs? They are important for giving the immunity, right? They are very important for, yes, liver is the place where the RBCs, sorry, why have you written liver? Yes, liver also regenerate. Yes, right. Liver also regenerate. So what is the function of the WBC? WBC main function is immunity, right? They are the soldiers of your body. They have the functioning of fighting with the infection. And it is not like that you are safe all the time. In society, it is felt that when we are at home, we are at the safest place. But it is not for our body. Body is always fighting. Every now and then it has to encounter so many of foreign elements, and these WBCs, platelets, they have to be active all the time, right? Jo aapka ye WBCs aur ye jo platelets hai, ye kya karte hai ki hamesha immunity develop karne ke liye rehta hai. To jitne bhi aapke body mein infections hote hain, infections ko rokne ke liye jo aapka ye WBCs hai wo hamesha kaam karta rehta hai. Because all these things na, they are your first defense. Kaun sa aapke body ka, what is the first defense, first line of defense? कौन सा चीज है जो सबसे पहले किसी भी फॉरेन एलिमेंट को आपके बॉडी में आने से रोकता है? Which is the first defense line of your body? Yes, correct. Very good, all of you. It is the skin, right? And when there is a breach in the skin, whenever there is a cut in the skin, जब भी आपका, it is very easy. Like अगर आपके घर पे दरवाजा है, अगर आपके घर पे walls है, तो आप protected हो. But जैसे आपका wall टूट जाएगा, तो बाहर के एलियंस, बाहर के फॉरेन एलिमेंट्स इजिली आपके घर के अंदर आ सकते हैं. द सेम थिंग इज विथ आवर बॉडी ऑल्सो. द स्किन इज लाइक अ वॉल. ओके. एंड इफ देर इज सम कटिंग और इंजरी और एनी ब्रीचिंग इन योर स्किन, ओनली एट दैट टाइम फॉरेन एलिमेंट्स विल एंटर योर बॉडी. Plus, there are other two places also. That is your mouth, because we are continuously chum 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 chum, we are talking continuously. So from mouth also, we are taking so many microorganisms. Okay, but in our this esophagus and also our windpipe, there are certain mechanisms. कुछ ऐसे वहां पर भी हमारे soldiers present हैं जो कि ये सारे सारे के सारे process को रोकते हैं. Plus nose also. ओके नोज ऑल्सो देर आर सर्टेन थिंग्स, देर आर सर्टेन सोल्जर, देर आर सर्टेन सेल्स जो कि कंटिन्यूअसली वर्क करता है एंड दे आर प्रोटेक्टिंग आवर बॉडी फ्रॉम ऑल दीज फॉरेन एलिमेंट्स. देन देर इज वन पार्ट इन योर बॉडी ओके विच डज नॉट टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द ब्लड विच इज दैट पार्ट ऑफ योर बॉडी विच इज दैट पार्ट ऑफ योर बॉडी विच डज नॉट टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द ब्लड. It will not take oxygen from the blood, which is that part. Name the part of the body which is no, not mouth or nose. Charmi nahi. Socho. हाँ माउथ और नोज से हम ओपनली लेते हैं. राइट राइट चार्मी. माउथ एंड नोज से हमारे अंदर फॉरेन ऑर्गेनिजम्स जो है वो जाता रहता है. फॉरेन ऑर्गेनिजम्स जो है वो अंदर की तरफ जाता है एंड वहां पर सोल्जर्स प्रेजेंट रहते हैं जो प्रोटेक्ट करते हैं हमारे बॉडी को. ओके द क्वेश्चन इज विच इज दैट ऑर्गन ऑफ आवर बॉडी विच डज नॉट टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द ब्लड. वो कौन सा ऑर्गन है हमारे बॉडी का जो ब्लड में से ऑक्सीजन नहीं लेता है. विच इज दैट ऑर्गन. द ऑर्गन इज योर आईज. द आईज ओके आईज इज द ओनली ऑर्गन ऑफ योर बॉडी विच विल डायरेक्टली टेक ऑक्सीजन फ्रॉम द एनवायरमेंट. देर आर कैपिलरीज प्रेजेंट बट मेजोरिटी ऑफ द ऑक्सीजन जो है दैट इज टेकन फ्रॉम द एटमोस्फेयर फ्रॉम द एयर इट इज टेकिंग. फाइन यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस. ओके this is one very important thing because our eyes have that that criteria. It has some liquid portion and everything, so wahan pe waisa hota hai. Fine. Yes, right, cornea. Yes, so let's come to our topic. So so the blood is continuously generating because we are in need of blood. Every time we need blood, we need WBCs. So what is the process of the formation of blood called? The process is called as hematopoiesis. What is it called? Hematopoiesis. Hematopoiesis matlab jahan par bhi word aata hai poiesis, poiesis ka matlab hota hai generation, generation. And hemato means what? ब्लड सेल्स. सो हिमैटोपोइसिस को अगर हम डिवाइड करेंगे इफ यू आर ब्रेकिंग द वर्ड हिमैटोपोइसिस इट विल बी लाइक फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ब्लड सेल्स. हिमैटोपोइसिस को अगर हम यस जेंसी जेनरेशन. सो हिमैटोपोइसिस को अगर हम ब्रेक करते हैं तो इसका मतलब होता है पोइसिस का मतलब होता है फॉर्मेशन. तो इसका मतलब होता है फॉर्मेशन ऑफ सेल्स, फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ब्लड सेल्स. इट इज नेवर रेड ब्लड सेल्स. ओके आपको ये नहीं समझना कि हिमैटोपोइसिस का मतलब होता है फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ओनली रेड ब्लड सेल्स. नो इट इज रॉन्ग. हिमैटोपोइसिस का मतलब होता है फॉर्मेशन ऑफ ब्लड सेल्स. सॉरी. सो दिस इज दिस सेंटेंस वाइज ना व्हेनेवर यू आर गिवन क्वेश्चंस फॉर निगेटिव सेंटेंसेस लाइक दिस सो दे विल गिव द क्वेश्चन लाइक दिस. What is the process of hematopoiesis? Formation of red blood cell, formation of white blood cells, both one and two, neither one and two. Like this questions comes in your exam. So it is both one and two. Okay, it is both red blood cell also and white blood cells also. Fine. So hematopoiesis is the formation of blood cells. Hello? Hello, am I audible?
Hello? Yes, ma'am, you're audible.
But I'm not.
Haan. Amit is facing network issue. The slide is not visible. Ab slide dekh pa rahe ho?
Nahin, nahin, wahi main bol rahi ki slide kahan gaya?
Amit?
I'm trying it on my laptop also, but in the app, I don't know why it is not opening. I have to reinstall it.
अमित आवाज आ रही है मेरी?
मदद करा
यस यस
स्लाइड शेयर करो।
हाँ
दिख रही है मैम आपको स्लाइड?
हाँ 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 मुझे दिख रही है स्लाइड।
नेक्स्ट स्लाइड मैम।
हाँ हाँ नेक्स्ट स्लाइड कर दीजिए। नेक्स्ट स्लाइड कर दीजिए। ओके नाउ सी हियर, नाउ दिस इज योर फुल जनरेशन ऑफ योर जनरेशन ऑफ योर ब्लड सेल्स। नाउ हियर यू हैव टू रिमेंबर सम इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स and you have to remember this chart because from directly one liner questions come directly from this chart. One liner questions can be asked. So now see from the top I am explaining. The first word is a multipotential hematopoietic stem cell. When we were discussing the stem cells at that time, we have mentioned these terms: totipotent, unipotent, multipotent. Remember everyone, what is the meaning of multipotent? What is the meaning of multipotent? From the chart, what you can this multipotent stem cell can give rise to so many types of cells. Okay, this one cell which is at the top called as the cytoblast, the hemocytoblast, it can give rise to so many types of the cells. At the end, there are so many different types. This is called as multipotent. When one cell can give to a to give to can give to many types of cells, can give rise to many types of cells, it is called as a multipotent. Multipotent ka matlab hota hai jab ek cell bahut sare cells ko rise karta hai, बट इसका मतलब ये नहीं होता कि वो पूरे के पूरे ऑर्गेनिजम्स को बना सकता है. दैट इज द डिफरेंस बिटवीन योर स्टेम सेल्स, टोटीपोटेंट और ये सारी चीजें. और आपको ये पता होना चाहिए कि जो मल्टीपोटेंट होता है वो बहुत सारे सेल्स को राइज कर सकता है. दैट इज व्हाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज मल्टीपोटेंट. मल्टी मीन्स मेनी मेनी सेल्स. फाइन. सो ये जो हिमाटो ये जो पूरा प्रोसेस है, दिस इज अ हिमाटोपोइसिस प्रोसेस. ये जो पूरा आपको चार्ट दिख रहा है, द चार्ट डिपिक्ट्स हिमाटोपोइसिस प्रोसेस. फाइन. एंड यू कैन सी देयर इज अ ग्रैंडफादर हियर एट द टॉप, एंड दिस ग्रैंडफादर हैज टू सन्स. वन सन इज माइलॉइड, द अदर सन इज लिम्फोइड. इट हैज टू सन्स. दिस ग्रैंडफादर हैज टू सन्स. दिस इज अ स्टेम सेल, द ग्रैंडफादर, एंड इट हैज two sons. One is a myeloid family, other is the lymphoid family. So what are the two what are the two sons, what are the two important cells from the hematopoietic stem cells which will give rise to whole number of cells? It can be converted to any cell. Yes, it can be converted to any cell, right? There are two sons. You have to remember the name of the two sons. Or you can remember it as two daughters who have been married in different family, and therefore they have these two different surname. myeloid and lymphoid. There are two different types, myeloid and lymphoid. Okay, now see here, in the myeloid we can see four types of cells, four different types of cells. The first big fat one is called as a megakaryocyte. The fat one is megakaryocyte. Now one question from here which can be asked in your NET exam is that what is responsible for the size of this megakaryocyte? Mega ka matlab hota hai bada and karyocyte ka matlab hota hai nucleus. I am giving you a hint. Mega ka matlab hota hai bada and karyo ka matlab hota hai nucleus. So if the question comes in your exam, what is the reason of the size of the megakaryocyte? What will be your answer? You can see the size of this megakaryocyte. The first cell, which is purple color here, the first one, which is purple and blue color, the term here written is megakaryocyte, and it is belonging to the family of myeloid. Okay, myeloid family. What is the reason of this megakaryocyte being this so fat? Bahut khata hai. Large nucleus. Yes, large nucleus. But what is the reason of this large nucleus? Why this large nucleus is present? Why not in other cases there is large nucleus? Division. Okay. Any other answer? No granules. Okay. Everyone can see the size of this megakaryocyte. Ekdam mota sa hai, ekdam fat, fat, fat. Why is this size? Kyun itna mota hai? Bahut khata hai? Yes, very good. This is the answer. Division of cells and DNA many times. Only one word is missing, that is no cell division. Very good, Charmi. Yes, DNA replication is happening so many times. Nucleus is not dividing. What happens is that when there is one cell, okay, when there is DNA replication, and then it will divide into two. So from one cell we will get two progeny cells. But here in megakaryocyte what happens is that there is no cell division and there is rapid multiplication of DNA. Bahut sara DNA replication hota hai par cell division nahi hota hai, cell divide nahi karta hai, but DNA jo hai wo multiply karta hota hai. This is the reason. Very good, Charming. This is the reason. Okay, and that is why ye jo hai ye megakaryocyte ye pura ka pura fragment ho jata hai, kyunki ye itna bada ho jata hai ki ye apne aap ko sambhal nahi sakta hai. And whenever there is some stimulus coming, we will study what are those stimulus. Whenever there is some stimulus coming, this megakaryocyte will break into fragments, and those fragments are called as thrombocytes or platelets. Understood? Those megakaryocytes are megakaryocyte will break, and megakaryocyte will make small fragments, and these fragments are called as thrombocytes or platelets. Jo thrombocytes hai, that is a scientific term. Okay, and platelets we use it in common terms, platelets. Now tell me one thing, platelets ke paas nucleus hota hai? Do platelets have nucleus? Yes or no? No. Yes, platelets do not have nucleus. Every time this question comes in your exam, that megakaryocyte has nucleus, but platelets do not have nucleus. Why platelets will not be having any nucleus? The reason is that This megakaryocyte is unstable and it is fragmenting, it is breaking down on some stimulus, on some cytokine, on some chemical stimulus it is breaking. It is not a normal cell division process. That is why iske andar koi bhi nucleus jaisa kuch bhi cheez nahi aata hai. Platelets jo hai, this megakaryocyte is so big ki agar kuch bhi aisa stimulus aayega to ye jo megakaryocyte hai pura ka pura fragment ho jayega. It is not an orderly process. It is not an orderly system. Agar wo order mein jata, agar first cell division ho raha hai, uske baad wo divide kar raha hai, and then we are getting two different cells. At that time, there is distinction ki, okay, the nucleus, this part of nucleus will go here, this part of nucleus will go here. But when megakaryocyte is formed, it does not have any kind of division. Okay. Any kind of division for the nucleus, and that is why when it is fragmented, thrombocytes will not have nucleus. So platelets are enucleated. E, wherever the term is E, E means no. Okay, E means no. That means the platelets do not have nucleus. The second is your erythrocytes. So your erythrocytes will give your red blood cells. Erythrocytes will give your red blood cells. Erythrocytes have a stimulation of a hormone called as erythropoietin. Only when erythropoietin is present, this erythrocytes will be formed from the myeloid progenitor cell. There are different stimulus. Okay, jaisa aapka stimulus hoga, वैसा आपका प्रोडक्ट बनेगा. इट इज ऑन डिमांड बेसिस. आप जो भी चीज, अगर आपको कोई चीज चाहिए, यू हैव टू गो एंड आस्क, राइट. इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन का अगर हम फिनोमिना देखेंगे, व्हाट इज द इंडस्ट्रियलाइजेशन में क्या होता है, द थिंग विच इज इन डिमांड इट विल बी प्रोड्यूस्ड इन मच मोर क्वांटिटी. द स्टिमुलस इज द कंज्यूमर. What whatever is in demand, it will be produced. So the same thing is for these red blood cells, WBCs, all the things. Whatever the cell will be in demand, that will be produced. And demand kaun batayega? Demand aapka batayega chemicals, the chemical secretion. Erythrocytes ke liye jo chemical secretion hai, that is called as erythropoietin. It is very, very important, erythropoietin. And erythropoietin दो जगह पे होता है, लिवर एंड किडनी. वॉट आर द ऑर्गन्स विच विल सिक्रीट erythropoietin? टू ऑर्गन्स. फर्स्ट इज लिवर, सेकेंड इज किडनी. अंडरस्टूड? फर्स्ट इज लिवर एंड सेकेंड इज किडनी. देर आर टू ऑर्गन्स विच विल गिव erythropoietin. फर्स्ट इज लिवर एंड सेकेंड इज किडनी. But liver is functional only when you are in fetus condition. Only in the fetus, liver will secrete your erythropoietin. Whenever you are growing older, it is, the function is taken over by the kidney. This question has come like hundreds of times in your all. You can see your JAM paper, JE papers, or your NET papers. Name the organ which secretes erythropoietin. Now, can you give the answer? Name the organ which gives erythropoietin. Which is the organ? Liver and kidney, both liver and kidney. And whenever it is coming in your analytical type, that is your in your part C, your NET paper has three parts, part A, part B, and part C. So in your part C type, this question will come in an experimental portion, or it can come like a story portion, that if there is a fetus and the fetus need blood or the RBC, which organ will help in the production of RBC? So there the answer will be yes. The answer will be liver. And what is the name of the chemical? It is erythropoietin. It is a hormone. It is a hormone. The hormone which will secreted by the cells, by the liver cells, by the kidney cells, which will come to this myeloid progenitor cell, and it will demand that give me erythrocyte. Mujhe RBC chahiye. it is like a money. Okay, erythropoietin is coming and it is telling that I want erythrocytes, I want RBC. Like if some blood loss is happening from your body, any accident, RBCs has been lost. So erythropoietin will be secreted. Kidney will sense that, because in the adult situation, it is the kidney. So kidney will sense that there is abnormal level of blood in your body. In our body, there should be average kitna hona chahiye? 5 liter to 6 liters blood hona chahiye. Jaise hi 5 liters se blood kam ho jayega, the kidney will sense this and it will start producing this erythropoietin. Aur jaise hi erythropoietin produce hoga, erythropoietin from this myeloid progenitor cell, it will start producing this erythrocytes. Fine. The next cell is your mast cells. Now, mast cell, you have to remember two words you have to remember in mast cell. First is, it is a granulocytic cell. Granulocytic ka matlab kya hota hai? Now, don't confuse it with the niche ka jo bhi aapko dikh raha hai na, basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil, isse confuse mat hona. Hum sirf abhi upar wala layer dekh rahe hai. Megakaryocyte, erythrocyte, now the third one is your mast cell. What is the meaning of granulocyte? Granulocyte. Yes, Millie, right. Granulocyte ka matlab hota hai, uske andar granules hain. That means these mast cell, you can see in the figure also, you can see that purple color ka dots, many small dots is present in this mast cell. That dots are called as granules. Okay. And who was the scientist who has first time discovered this mast cell? Can you name it? Can you name him? Name the scientist who discovered mast cells. Name the scientist who discovered mast cell. This is a one-liner question of your exam. Name the scientist who discovered mast cells. Ehrlich, yes, very good, Charmi. It is Paul Ehrlich. It is Paul Ehrlich. PaulEhrlich. Paul Ehrlich. Paul Ehrlich was the scientist who discovered this mast cells. And what are these granules basically? What are the granules? What are the granules? The granules are actually the enzymes. The granules are actually enzymes. When we see the function of this mast cell, you will understand that why it needs so many enzymes. What is the function of this mast cell? It is very active in your allergy condition. Allergy. Whenever there is an allergy condition in your body, the first cell which comes to your rescue is the mast cell. जब भी आपको कुछ भी एलर्जिक रिएक्शंस होता है आपके बॉडी में, दीज आर द मास्ट सेल्स विच आर द एक्टिव सेल्स जो कि आपके एलर्जिक रिएक्शंस में आता है. ओके, दे आर द मास्ट सेल्स. एंड मास्ट सेल्स के अंदर एंजाइम्स होते हैं, केमिकल्स होते हैं, एंड दीज केमिकल्स एंड एंजाइम्स गिव इट अ ग्रैन्युलर स्ट्रक्चर. यू शुड नो कि क्यों उसके अंदर ग्रैन्युल्स है. एवरीथिंग इन नेचर इज because of its function. Whatever is its physical appearance, its chemical nature, whatever is there, that is just because of its functioning process. Uska ek evolutionary process kya tha, and us evolutionary process ki wajah se uska function kya define hua hai. Because of that only the structure has been created in the nature. The mast cell has so many granules because it has to work on the allergic reactions, and in these allergic reactions it has to give this enzymes, the chemicals. So that is why these mast cells are granulated cells. Understood? Yes, enzymes, immune cells. Yes, they are not actually you can call this immune cells, but mostly they are present in your allergic reactions, mast cell. Then is your last member of this myeloid progenitor cell, called as the myeloblast, and this myeloblast gave rise to your white blood cells. The myeloblast will give rise to your white blood cells. ये जो आपको नीचे का जितना भी सेल का टाइप्स दिख रहा है, बेसोफिल, न्यूट्रोफिल, इओसिनोफिल, मोनोसाइट्स, ऑल दीज आर डिफरेंट डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ योर डब्ल्यूबीसी सेल्स, वाइट ब्लड सेल्स. नाउ यू कैन सी फ्रॉम दिस थिंग दैट माइलॉइड इज द कॉमन पैरेंट फॉर योर एरिथ्रोसाइट सेल एंड फॉर योर डब्ल्यूबीसी सेल, बट उनका जो पेरेंट्स है वो अलग अलग है एंड दोनों के कंडीशंस भी अलग अलग होंगे. ओके, एरिथ्रोसाइट्स के लिए एरिथ्रोपोइटिन इंपॉर्टेंट है. फॉर एरिथ्रोसाइट इट इज एरिथ्रोपोइटिन एंड फॉर माइलोब्लास्ट इट इज GSF. इट इज कॉल्ड एज सॉरी इट इज कॉलोनी स्टिमुलेटिंग फैक्टर CSF. सॉरी It is colony stimulating factor CSF. That is the hormone. It will go and demand this myeloid progenitor cell to make this myeloblast, and this myeloblast will give different types of WBC cells. Okay, so you should know two things here. Myeloblast is the progenitor cell for all the WBC cells, and second thing, it will be formed only in the presence of colony stimulating factor CSF. Colony stimulating factor. Colony stimulating factor. Colony stimulating factor जब present होगा तभी ये myeloblast cell इतने सारे आपके WBCs को बनाएगा. Now here one question. Now tell me whether myeloblast cell is a totipotent cell, a multipotent cell, or a unipotent cell. What is the stand of myeloblast cell? What is the stand of myeloblast? Multipotent, multipotent. Okay, okay, okay. Okay, so everyone is telling multipotent. But the answer is it is a unipotent cell. The multipotent cell is your first cell. Jo aapka first ekdam top mein jo grandfather baitha hai na, sirf grandfather hai jo ki multipotent hai, kyunki grandfather ke paas bahut sara property hai and wo bahut sara property ko usne apne dono bachchon mein divide kar diya hai. And इनके ये जो दो बच्चे होंगे, अब इनका जो प्रॉपर्टी है वो कैसा होता जाएगा, कम 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 होता जाएगा, राइट? व्हाटएवर इज द प्रॉपर्टी विद दिस माइलॉइड एंड इट इज हैविंग फोर डॉटर्स और फोर सन्स, सो व्हाट विल बी हैपनिंग, द प्रॉपर्टी विल बी डिक्रीजिंग एंड डिक्रीजिंग विद इंक्रीजिंग जनरेशन. अगर ये लोग दैट इज अनदर स्टोरी कि इफ दे आर मेकिंग देयर ओन प्रॉपर्टीज एंड एवरीथिंग, आई एम जस्ट टेलिंग अबाउट द इनहेरिटेंस फैक्टर. ओके, so myeloblast is a unipotent, it is a unipotent. Now you will ask me that it is making so many types of cell, it is making basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil, monocyte, right? But all these cells are what, they are type of only one cell, that is WBCs. Yes, only one type it is, WBC. These basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil, they are different. They are different on the basis of their function. They are on the basis of their structure and function, they are different. But what is their common nature? It is a white blood cell. Okay, it is a white blood cell. White blood cells ke wo different cells zarur hai, but wo different cells kyun hote hain? On the basis of condition, wo different cells mein badalte hain. It is not completely different type. Like erythrocyte is a different type. WBC is a different type. Megakaryocyte is a different type. Okay, but myeloblast ke andar ye jitne bhi cells hai, they are of only one type, that is WBC. So what is the stand of myeloblast cell? Now give me the answer. What is the stand of myeloblast cell? Yes, it is a unipotent. It is unipotent. The doubt is cleared. Right now, this is the places, these are the places where you are ought to get confused and when these type of questions comes in your exam, obviously you are tend to making mistakes and everything. So here what should be done, the concept should be very 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 fine and the concept should be very clear. Only at that time you can solve these analytical types of questions. Fine, there are some questions which you have to mug up. In that thing you can't do, you have to mug up. But there are many questions and there are many concepts where your conceptual knowledge work, where your logical reasoning works. So this is a kind of logical question. Okay, so myeloblast is a unipotent cell and it will give rise to all these types of the cell, the basophil, neutrophil, eosinophil, monocyte cell. We will see each and every type in our consecutive slides. Okay, now this family is over. The myeloid family, we have finished. Fine. Any doubt in this family? Myeloid family, any doubt? Any doubt in this myeloid family? Now I am going little bit slow because these concepts are very important for your NET exam, for your each and every exam. It is very important. Fine, clear. Everything is clear. Okay. Now let's move to the next family. The next family is very good because it is very small family. Okay. And the family, what is the surname of that family? The lymphoid. Now I have told you in the last classes also. What is the meaning of progenitor cell? That is why I have not explained here this time. Progenitor matlab, wo progenitor cells are the first cell, the precursor cell. Progenitor means it will give rise to different types of the cells. Okay, that is why it is called a progenitor and it is a immature cells. Okay, it is a immature cell. Now one question, what will make the progenitor cell a mature cell? What will make a progenitor cell a mature cell? What will make a progenitor cell a mature cell? I have given the answer. What will make a progenitor cell a mature cell? Bone marrow mein jo immature cells hi present hote hain. बोन मैरो में इमेच्योर सेल्स प्रेजेंट होता है. सेल डिवीजन, ओके, सेल डिवीजन इज लाइक आपने ना डायरेक्टली थर्ड स्टेप पे चढ़ गए, थर्ड सीढ़ी पे कूद गए आप. व्हाट आर द फर्स्ट टू इनिशियल स्टेजेस? यू आर जंपिंग, जंपिंग जैंसी, यू आर ऑल्सो जंपिंग. सेल डिवीजन डिपेंडिंग ऑन फंक्शन विल बी लाइक द टॉप गियर. मिली आप एकदम सीधा, आपने हाई जम्प लगा के आप एकदम एकदम लास्ट वाले स्टेप पे कूद गए. What will be the first thing? Progenitor को अगर हमको mature cell में बदलना, what will be the first thing? मैंने अभी आपको बताया था. In this myeloid family मैंने आपको बताया था. Yes, very good. It is the growth factor, the signaling. Signaling मैंने आपको बताया था ना, आपको ये याद रखना है, ये जितने भी progenitor cells होते हैं ना, they are very lazy, बहुत lazy होते हैं ये सारे. ओके, अगर इनको आपको फंक्शनिंग करवाना है तो आपको इनको स्टिमुलेट करना पड़ेगा. यू हैव टू स्टिमुलेट देम. एंड व्हाट आर दी स्टिमुलेटिंग फैक्टर्स? दीज आर द केमिकल सिग्नल्स. द इट मे बी एनीथिंग, नॉट नेसेसरी द ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स, बट इट कैन बी एनीथिंग. द साइटोकाइंस, द ग्रोथ फैक्टर्स और एनी अदर स्टिमुलस, इट कैन बी एनीथिंग. लाइक अगर मास्ट सेल्स को अगर आपको एक्टिवेट करना है तो आपके बॉडी में एलर्जिक रिएक्शन होना चाहिए. लाइक सम पीपल हैव एलर्जी टू डस्ट, राइट? मेनी पीपल हैव एलर्जी टू डस्ट. सम हैव एलर्जी टू पोलन ग्रेन्स, सम हैव एलर्जी टू मशरूम्स. बट हमारे बॉडी को पता कैसे चलते कि मेरे बॉडी को उस चीज से एलर्जी है? हाउ वी विल कम टू नो दैट दैट वी आर हैविंग एलर्जी? बिकॉज सम फिजियोलॉजिकल डिफरेंसेस आर सीन. कुछ हमारे बिहेवियर पैटर्न में चेंज आता है, कुछ फिजियोलॉजी में चेंजेस आता है. देर आर सम चेंजेस इन आवर बिहेवियर. लाइक इफ यू आर गोइंग इन डस्ट एंड वी हैव एलर्जी टू डस्ट, सम विल गेट पिंपल्स, सम विल गेट स्नीजिंग, अ लॉट ऑफ स्नीजिंग, राइट? नाउ वाई दैट स्नीजिंग इज कॉज्ड? Sneezing is caused because these mast cells in our nose, these mast cells are present and they will start secreting their enzymes. एंड दीज एंजाइम्स देन विल स्टार्ट द फुल नीचे का जो प्रोसेस है वो पूरा का पूरा शुरू कर देगा वो. एंड दीज आर सो क्विक इन फ्रैक्शन ऑफ सेकेंड दे विल स्टार्ट फंक्शनिंग एंड दे विल स्टार्ट गिविंग योर बिहेवियरल चेंजेस एंड यू विल अंडरस्टैंड ओके आई एम एलर्जिक टू दिस राइट. यू शुड नो दिस दैट वॉट हाउ दीज फंक्शंस हैपन हाउ दीज प्रोसेस बिगिंस इट इज थ्रू सम केमिकल्स थ्रू सम स्टिमुलस दैट स्टिमुलस कैन बी एनीथिंग anything that stimulus can be anything okay not necessarily chemical physical stimulus biological stimulus chemical stimulus but the word is stimulus okay agar aapko stimulus agar aap stimulus nahi provide karoge bone marrow cells hamesha wo bone marrow hi bana rahega from bone marrow never 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 red blood cells or white blood cells they will never be generated okay whenever there is demand you should know this thing jab demand hoga tabhi cheeze banengi warna nahi banengi and wo demand kaun show karega stimulus show karega ya wo stimulus kuch bhi ho sakta hai the stimulus can be anything it can be physical biological chemical koi sa bhi stimulus ho sakta hai understood everyone clear hai just comment okay fine clear okay so let's go to the second family this is the lymphoid family now what is the difference between this myeloid family and lymphoid family is that this lymphoid family is particularly focusing on the immunity particularly focusing on the immune system ye ekdam totally dedicated hai immune system ke liye agar aap myeloid progenitor cells mein dekhenge to inke paas aur bhi other functions hote hain they have some different functions also like megakaryocytes have blood clotting erythrocytes have oxygen distribution myeloblasts ye basophil neutrophils ke bhi different functions hote hain but lymphoid progenitor cell it is like border security forces matlab usko border pe hi khada hona hai usne apne aap ko destine kar liya hai ki it will stand and it will protect okay so there are two important types first is your natural killer cells now natural killer cells are very very important in your virus and cancer cells the question in your net exams how it is asked is that name the cells which are active to kill the viruses or name the lymphoid progenitor cells which is produced in high numbers when the cancer cells are present in the body what is that cell NK cells yes the cells are natural killer cells now from the name only you can suggest it is killing natural killer means it is naturally present in our body from the normal progenitor it is coming from our body so it is naturally present and it is killing it is a killer like the soldiers who are present on the Kargil or like nowadays there is Galwan Valley so much we are facing the resistance that at Pangso so lake we are facing so much resistance and whatever what the soldiers are there doing if any breaching is there from the Chinese they will just use their guns and they will shoot them right the natural killer cell is also the same function they will just shoot the viruses they will just shoot the cancer cells fine so natural killer cells are very important in your virus infections and in your cancer cells they have a very important functions in cancer cells also they have very important function now the second is your lymphocyte cells now there are two types of lymphocytes one is your T lymphocytes and one is your B lymphocytes now whatever antibody production is there in your body the five different types of antibodies which are there in your body that is because of your B lymphocytes how you will remember antibodies anti Bodies, B for bodies, B for B lymphocytes. So B lymphocytes will give antibodies. And what is the special cells called which produce the B lymph, the antibodies? They are the plasma cells. They are the plasma cells which will produce your antibodies. Understood? They are like memory cells. Memory cells. Once there is any infection in your body, these B lymphocytes, ये क्या करेगा? Memory बना के रखेगा. Okay, इस बार इस virus ने infect किया था, तो मैंने ये वाला antibody बनाया था. तो जब भी next time वही same virus encounter करेगा, again वो वापस से वही वाला antibodies बनाएगा. These B lymphocytes, what they are doing? They are creating a memory in their genes, in their brain. Unka brain kya hai? Their genes, their DNA. That is their brain. Okay, and that brain they will memorize. Okay, this time this virus or this time this bacteria. Now the difference between natural killer and lymphocyte is lymphocyte target a whole bunch of pathogenic organism, but natural killer cell basically and mostly viruses and cancer cells. But these lymphocytes, they will target your fungus, bacterias, your viruses, your all types of parasitic organisms they can deal with. So these B lymphocytes are antibody producing cells, and the name of that cell is your plasma cell. And these T lymphocytes, they are very important in cell mediated immunity. Very important in cell mediated immunity. We will be not going into detail here in immunology, but you just remember one word here, cell mediated immunity, because in your exam this question is asked that name the cell which is responsible for cell mediated immunity, and the options will be T lymphocytes, B lymphocytes, both T lymphocytes and B lymphocytes, and the next option will be none. So what will be your answer? What will be your answer? Both T lymphocyte. Specifically, if it is for cell mediated, it is T lymphocyte. And antibody, if it is for innate and adaptive both, then it is both. Okay, but if it is specifically cell mediated, it is T lymphocyte. Okay, it is T lymphocyte. You have to remember this thing. And B lymphocyte is majorly, it is for antibody production. Obviously, it is an immune cell which is giving the antibodies and it is protecting your body. But cell mediated and humoral, it is a humoral type of response. Antibodies jo hoti hai na, usko hum humoral response bolte hai. Okay, humoral response. Aur cell mediated jo hai, wo ek other response hai. To dono ke liye alag alag types of cells hai jo ki responsible hota hai. Agar koi bhi aapko immunology padhata hai ya kabhi maine aapko immunology padhaya, to I will make you understand that what is humoral and what is this. But till here, matlab कि लिम्फोसाइट्स में जो आपको याद रखनी है दो चीजें, वो ये है टी लिम्फोसाइट सेल मीडिएटेड इम्यूनिटी, दैट्स इट, ओनली वन वर्ड. एंड फॉर बी लिम्फोसाइट इट इज एंटीबॉडीज ओनली. अंडरस्टूड? बी लिम्फोसाइट्स आर ऑफ टू टाइप्स, मेमोरी सेल्स एंड प्लाज्मा सेल्स, नॉट प्लाज्मा सेल्स ओनली, राइट? यस Yes, you are right. But these plasma cells only, these plasma cells now, they will secrete the antibodies. And these plasma cells only will make the memory cells. Okay. These plasma cells will only make the memory cells. Memory for the different types of the pathogens. Okay. But plasma cells, what is their function? They will just secrete the antibodies. A type, B type, E type, IgG, IgG, IgM. They will secrete these type of antibody, but plasma cells only will mature into the memory cells. If suppose they have encountered a specific type of bacteria, so for that specific type of bacteria they have prepared some antibody. So wo kya karega, wo memory cell apne mein incorporate kar lega, and that memory cell will be now inactive. जब तक कि दूसरा दूसरे टाइम दैट इंफेक्शन इज नॉट अकरिंग इन आवर बॉडी. ओके, बट दिस प्लाज्मा सेल्स विल बी एक्टिव ऑल द टाइम, दे विल एट ऑल द टाइम दे विल बी गिविंग दिस एंटीबॉडीज. अंडरस्टूड जयंसी? ओके, आई थिंक वी शुड स्टॉप हियर. आई थिंक इट्स बहुत सारा हो गया क्वेश्चंस. अभी कुछ एनी क्वेश्चंस यू हैव? नाउ दिस चार्ट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट एंड वी टुक अराउंड 45 मिनट्स टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस, बट दिस चार्ट इज वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. यू शुड नो ईच एंड एवरी सेल ऑफ दिस फैमिली, यू नो, यू शुड रिमेंबर दिस फैमिली ट्री. And each and every member of this family has distinct functions, and you should know what is that function of that antibody. Any question you have, anything you understood today's lecture?
Thank you, ma'am. Very nice presentation. So, students, if you have any question regarding today's topic, please comment.
You can ask me anything 100 times. I will explain you 100 times. And never hesitate to ask anything. Huh? You can ask me anything, any damn. Every question is a stupid question. And every, I'm also, it is like you should ask questions. Then only you will become intelligent. So never become stupid. Okay, ask questions. Whatever types of questions you have, never hesitate. Do prokaryotes have brain? I mean, prokaryotes, brain is a very organized, because on Earth, it is like humans are the top level. Okay, abhi tak humans se sabse zyada evolved, abhi tak kuch bhi nahi hua hai. There is in nature, there is something which is evolving. Okay, so ho sakta hai ki like after 100 years, some more evolutionary dominant creatures than men can be formed. But at present, humans are the dominant and the most well-structured forms which are present on the earth, and they have this well characterized brain and jo ekdam fully developed jo brain hota hai. Prokaryotes kya hai, jab hum aapko evolution when we are seeing this path, prokaryotes to ekdam first layer hai, ekdam first level, but yes, so isliye unke andar koi brain jaisa system nahi hota hai. But when we go up in the evolutionary process na, there are little neural networks which have started being formed. They are called as neural networks. Okay, aisa kuch complete brain nahi hota, but small neural networks hote hain. But wo bhi aapko aise amoebas aur in sab mein nahi milega, not unicellular organism. Jahan se compartmentalization shuru ho jata hai na, in the eukaryotes. In the eukaryotes, you will start seeing this, the neural networks. And from there, these neural forms have started. Okay. So as such, agar puchenge prokaryotes mein hota hai, toh it is no. Brain jaisa kuch bhi nahi hota hai prokaryotes mein. Because they are the very basic form. It's sabse first level hai. Wahan se toh like life has started. Okay. So prokaryotes ko brain se jodna, that is not correlative. Okay. Then how their body work? Okay. See, our body communication is the thing, right? This brain, what is the function of the brain? The brain function, because we are human, we can think, and we can communicate, we can talk, and we can do all the stuffs. But can prokaryotes do that? Can prokaryotes talk? Can prokaryotes communicate? Can prokaryotes do the compartmentalizations of the things like us? Can it do? No, it cannot do, na? But what is the important function for a prokaryote? It is, they should respire, they should eat the things, they should grow, and they should divide. And after division or after some times, they will die. And for all these things, they don't need a brain. Okay, they don't need a brain. Their cells are that active. Their cells have, if they want food, if suppose I'm talking about amoeba. Amoeba is present in the water. Okay, and when it is formed, it is very small. But because of the what is called that struggle of existence and whatever those factors of Charles Darwin, if we know, if it has to survive, it has to eat. It has to fight from the all the predators and whatever the things are present in its nearby surrounding and environment. So it is the behavioral pattern. वो सब environment उनको सिखाता है. उसके लिए brain की जरूरत नहीं होती है. Brain जो है that is for communication and everything. And for communication and everything in their body, in their system, they have different things, they have different chemicals, they have different chemical secretions. Okay, understood? Like major jo bhi functions rehta hai, isiliye to na, that is why evolution is occurring. Evolution has started, why? Because it is called the necessity is the mother of invention. So like if you see in the evolutionary process, Lamarck's you have seen camels, right? Giraffes, they have so long neck that like before 1000 years back, giraffe were size of a dog. But why they have got so long neck? That is because of the food habits, the struggle for existence. In that process, they have started raising their necks because at that time, there were so many herbivores which were present on the earth. And so all the grasses jo ki niche present tha at their level, that all got emptied, that all got over. So for living, for survival, these giraffes, they have started pushing their necks, they have started pressing their necks upward, pulling their necks upward so that they can reach out to the higher trees and everything so that they can eat from there and they can survive. And that pulling, now it has got so long that, you know, giraffe has the longest neck. So it is the environmental factor, it is the environment. धीरे धीरे what happens कि मतलब prokaryotes में सब कुछ नहीं होता. prokaryotes कितने दिन तक जिंदा रह सकता है, उसको कितना सारा factors रहता है जो कि उसको harmful हो सकता है. That has created nature to make more advanced creatures and more technically strong creatures. And that is why humans are there on earth and that is why we are exploiting everything. Understood, Chami?
Now, students, if you have any question, please comment.
How antibody will form in our body, how they will identify that which antibody should be produced. It is on the basis of the structure. Now see, this coronavirus, it is entering our body, but our body is not able to recognize it. Now see, it is like a kind of imprinting. Okay, it is like a kind of imprinting. Now a little baby, okay, can he or she recognize his or her mother? Even though their brain is not that developed, but they can recognize the touch. Okay, the small birds, okay, they can very well recognize all the ducks are same, all the ducks are all the buffaloes, all the cows, everyone are looking the same for us, they are the same. But their children, they can very well recognize their mother. That is why that is because of the imprinting process. Okay, the same thing is here also. These viruses, these bacteria, they have a surface. They have a surface which have certain important surface features. And our immune cells, they will recognize those features. And there are certain things called as epitopes and paratopes. Okay, don't go into that depth. But it is like we recognize those structures. Our body, now we can recognize who are our family members. But if any outsider comes in our family, we can very well recognize na ki no, it is outsider. That is because we have developed that sense. Our body cells have also developed that sense. They have our all body system, they have certain surface characters which one cell can communicate with the other cell through the chemicals, through the secretions, through everything, and they know very well which is our body cells and which is not. So whenever there is a foreign element entering our body will start rejecting it. Why is cancer so difficult to treat? Because it is our body cell. It is like a traitor, ghar ka bhedi lanka dhaye. It is our body cell which is which has started revolting its counterparts. That is why it is very difficult to treat. But if any outsider comes, our whole body cells, it will stand together unitedly and it can fight. So in that fight, these antibodies are produced. They will recognize the surface structures. And on the basis of the surface structures, they will produce the antibodies which will go and fit those surface structures. And wo uska kuch vital functioning jo rehta hai, usko wo block kar deta hai. In that way, it is recognizing. And memory cells kaise banta hai? It is like kuch kuch parts rehta hai. Abhi jo CRISPR technology hai, it is fully based on the memory technology. Viruses aata hai aapke body mein, and viruses ka kuch portion rehta hai jo ki prokaryotes apne DNA mein incorporate kar leta hai. Okay, and jab next time dusra next time wahi virus aayega, to wo jo DNA ka portion rahega na, virus prokaryote cells jo rahega, bacterial cells jo rahega, wo usko identify kar lega ki okay, I have encountered this, and it will start making the antibody, it will start producing the jo bhi resistant hai uska, jo bhi defensive mechanisms, it will start producing that. Understood? Clear? मतलब आई हैव गिवन अ वेग स्टोरी, एकदम टिपिकली मैंने एकदम डेप्थ में जाके इम्यूनोलॉजी के फैक्ट से नहीं बताया, बट कंसेप्ट वाइज यू शुड नो द थिंग्स. तो मैंने कंसेप्चुअली आपको बताया मिली. ओके, इट इज द सरफेस. कोरोना वायरस के लिए क्यों एंटीबॉडीज डेवलप नहीं हो रहा? बिकॉज अवर बॉडी इज नॉट एबल टू रिकॉग्नाइज इट्स स्ट्रक्चर. वो सरफेस बार बार चेंज कर रहा है. द म्यूटेशन जो हो रहा है ना कोरोना वायरस में, द म्यूटेशन विच इज हैपनिंग इन दिस कोरोना वायरस, इट इज चेंजिंग इट्स आउटर स्ट्रक्चर. एंड एवरी टाइम वेन इट इज एंटरिंग अवर बॉडी, एवरी टाइम फॉर अवर बॉडी सेल्स इट इज न्यू. Every time it is new, for every time it has to make a new kind of antibody, and that is not possible for the for